Welcome. In this lecture, you will be introduced to an approach with which we aim to set up a picture of how the energy demand of a country may look like in the future. The energy demand from the industry, transport, services, and residential sector is very important for the strategies that energy companies set out and for the energy policies by government. It is by nature uncertain, and it depends on the three factors we have already discussed before: volume, structure, and energy efficiency. Now imagine you are a consultant hired by the government of Delftia to determine the development of the energy demand until 2030. In this lecture, you will be guided through some basic steps in order to conduct this task. Now, first things first, we should analyze the current situation of Delftia. In order to construct future scenarios, we need to understand the current situation first. In 2015, there were about 1 million Delftians, while the economy boosted a GDP of $20 billion. In the past 10 years, the population has shown an increase of 1%, while the economy grew by 2.5% annually. And this is the energy demand part of the energy balance in 2015 for Delftia. In the total energy use of 146 petajoule, we see that industry and transport have the highest share, whereas the share is still modest in the service sector. To make the next step in determining Delftia's energy use in 2030, we will start with a business as usual scenario. A scenario for which it is assumed that there will be no interventions to make a transition to a sustainable energy economy. When we analyze the current economic developments in Delftia, the following developments are expected until 2030. First of all, we assume that the population will grow 0.5% annually, according to government projections. The economy will grow by 2% per year. With regards to the sectoral developments, it is expected that the service sector will grow the strongest at 2.5% per year, while the industry will grow at only 1% per year. Households will also grow by 1% per year and transportation by 2% per year. In the business as usual scenario, we assume that the energy efficiency keeps improving at 1% per year. The only exception is the transport sector. In recent years, we have seen much more efficient cars entering the market. We expect that in 2030, the car fleet will use at least 25% less fuel per kilometer, which is an improvement of 2% per year. So, how do we calculate the future energy use? We start from the 2015 values for the energy use. We multiply this with a growth factor to take into account sectoral growth. Finally, we multiply the result with a factor to take into account the energy efficiency improvement. This can be done per sector to take into account the specific sectoral growth and efficiency improvements. For instance, if we fill in this equation for the electricity use in the service sector, this means that in 2030, the energy use will increase from 7 to 9 petajoule. If we do this for all sectors, this is the picture you get: the development of the energy use for all sectors from 2015 until 2030. The blue line at the top indicates the sum of all sectors, or the total TFC. And here is the business as usual energy balance for 2030, which is compared to the 2015 energy balance. It has a modest increase of the TFC of 253 petajoule over all sectors together. And although the population is increasing, we see that the efficiency improvements are just sufficient to not increase the residential energy use. The same cannot be said for transport and services, where the sectoral growth outpaces the efficiency improvement, leading to a higher energy use in 2030. However, things are about to change in Delftia. The government is implementing new policies. Massive insulation and appliance efficiency programs will speed up energy efficiency improvement in the residential and service sector to 4% per year. For industry, this will be 2% per year. Furthermore, a 20% biofuel blending obligation is introduced. But also, we see an increased interest in electric transportation, leading to a share of 20% electric vehicles in 2030. The sectoral developments are assumed to remain the same as in the business as usual scenario. Let's take a look at how the energy use section of Tudelsia's energy balance may look like in 2030. The calculation to get to this energy balance is in principle the same as for the business as usual scenario. However, there are some complexities in the transport sector due to the new measures. If no new policy would have been implemented in the transport sector, the energy use would be 41 petajoule, fully covered by oil in 2030. Just like in the business as usual scenario. But due to the large-scale implementation of electric vehicles, 20% of what would have been oil use in 2030, around 8 petajoule, is substituted with electricity. Note that for electric vehicles you need less energy, about 60% less, in the form of electricity per kilometer than you would have needed in the form of gasoline for conventional cars. This means that the increase in the electricity used for transportation is also 60% less than the oil it replaces. From the remaining energy used by transport, 33 petajoule or 20%, is replaced by the same amount of biofuels. This leaves 26 petajoule of oil use by the transport sector in 2030, significantly less than in the business as usual scenario. Furthermore, you can notice a strong decrease in the total energy use relative to the 2015 situation. Efficiency measures can thus be a very effective tool to curtail the energy use, even though the economy and population is growing. In the total electricity use, there is also a decrease taking place, this even though the electric vehicles are introduced. The strong efficiency improvement in the residential and service sector can be considered the main driver behind this decrease. In this way, electric vehicles can be introduced without the need to add new power generation capacity. And this is the development of the energy use per sector. It is nice to see that although the population and economy are growing, the total final consumption of energy is decreasing for the new wind scenario, represented by the dotted lines. In the business as usual scenario, it was still slightly growing, as you can see in the solid lines. This means that for Tudelsia, energy efficiency improvement and change of energy carriers for transport can significantly reduce energy requirements. The scenario does provide the government with information on how their policies may impact the energy demand, while the energy companies are provided with information on how to plan for the future. The lower energy demand in the new wind scenario will make it easier to cover a large fraction from renewable sources. In the next lecture, we will discuss how the energy supply of Tudelsia may evolve, as we will develop scenarios for energy supply then.